Welcome everybody to Monday Night Raw. We are starting off Raw with a battle royal. We already have some superstars in the ring, as you can tell. And we're starting off with Sheamus again. Boom. Sheamus has been on a roll the last few weeks, defeating, so far it's 2-0. So this is, you know, looking great towards Sheamus winning this battle royal. There are six competitors, Sheamus being one of them, Seth Rollins being the second one. Hasn't appeared since the draft night. So, we also got Baron Corbin. We also got The Miz. And Neville. So now we just have one superstar left after Sheamus. Let's find out who it is. Whoa! Wait just a minute! The greatest man that ever lived, Austin Aries, is back! Austin Aries has been out since SummerSlam after Orton defeated him. I think I forgot to mention why this is, why this is happening. This battle royal is happening because the winner will face the United States champion Randy Orton at Clash of Champions. So, seeing Aries back, and maybe he can get one more shot at facing the Viper, Randy Orton. The Viper will be in action tonight against The Big Show. And we also got a tag match. Continuing from the tournament, because there's going to be a tournament going on. The winner will be determined at Clash of the Champions, and they will become the new WWE Raw Tag Team Champions because the Dudley Boys retired while holding them. Look at everybody going after each other. Rollins going after Miz. Aries going after Corbin. And Sheamus going after Neville. Oh, look at Miz. Miz is close to elimination, but he stays in. And now Neville looking to eliminate Sheamus. Miz looking to eliminate Rollins. Look at Aries now. Well, Aries eliminate Corbin. Drop kick. Corbin's out of the match. Look at the strength of Neville lifting up Sheamus like that. I'm looking at Aries. He's looking pretty confident right now. Rollins. Oh, nice kick from Rollins. Sheamus and Neville going after each other still. Oh, look at Aries helping out Sheamus to eliminate Neville. Oh, Neville's eliminated. Oh, look at it. Aries quickly going after Sheamus. Miz, Rollins, Aries, and Sheamus are the only ones left in the match. Aries now thrown over the top, but he stays in.
Again, the concept of this match is to be the last man standing in the center of the
Sheamus and Aries back in the ring. Ooh. Oh, what a nice little backbreaker and Russian leg sweep right there. And look at Miz looking to eliminate Rollins. Oh, Aries looking to eliminate Rollins. This might happen. Oh, Rollins is out. And Sheamus looking to get rid of Miz. This might happen. Oh, he's out. Oh, but look at Aries. Aries. He's trying to do a finisher, but I messed up. It went. Like, well, I didn't mess up. It just wouldn't go. Anyway, oh, Aries eliminates Sheamus. Austin Aries will face Randy Orton one more time. And it's going to be a clash of the champions. Will Aries finally be able to beat Randy Orton? He was unable to do it at Clash of the Champ or at SummerSlam. Will he be able to do it at Clash of the Champions? What an opening contest. Aries gets the win by eliminating Sheamus. Alright, let's head into our next match. Here we go. Chicago, Illinois is in for a fun night. And here comes a fan favorite from Raw. It's Bayley, the women's champion. Bayley set to face Nikki Bella at Clash of the Champions for the Women's Championship. Nikki Bella did attack Bayley, but Nikki did deserve it after beating the Women's Champion on Raw. But now, Bayley's going to go one-on-one with her SummerSlam opponent, the woman she beat to win that Raw Women's Champion, Paige. There she comes. There's Paige. And approaching the ring from Norwich, England, Paige. This place is deafening. Listen to it. When you're as good as this. Paige getting ready for action. You know, Paige has kind of been in the middle of all of this since the SummerSlam match. You know, she went up against Bayley, and like I said, she lost. Nikki Bella attacked Bayley after the match. And Paige has fought both Nikki Bella and Bayley. You know, she's been in the middle of this feud, really. And this is a huge opportunity for her to beat Bayley, because it gives her a possible chance at facing the women's champion. Oh, going after the leg of Paige. And you know Nikki Bella is definitely watching close by. These women absolutely hate each other. And it's definitely shown in the past weeks. It's been super intense. Haven't seen a feud like this in a while. And look at Bayley with a suplex. Bayley is just dominating this matchup so far. Wait, whoa. Oh, she's going after Bayley and Paige. Oh my God. Isn't that a DQ? It might be a while before she finds her footing now. She's having a real hard time getting back to her feet. Isn't that a DQ, ref? She's on a roll now. Wait. Oh, shit. I want to go after freaking Nikki. Look at this! Oh, what a drop! These girls, look at this! I told you they absolutely hate each other! Paige, get your bitch ass out of here. Come on, punch me, I dare you, bitch. Damn! Look at Bayley now! This is intense, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at Paige! Oh! Going for the pin and kicks out at one. I guess it wasn't a DQ. I thought it would have been. And Nikki's just, why isn't the ref like trying to get her out? That's what I'm wondering. She's just allowed to watch the match. look at Bayley. Neckbreaker. Oh, she closed. Wow. What a clothesline from out of there. Look at this. Oh, Bayley to belly, but Paige reversed. Paige reversed the Bayley to belly. Oh, but look at this. Oh, Paige Turner. No way. One, two, three. Paige gets the win. Wow. Huge victory right there. Paige will definitely get a future women's match for the title. She just beat the women's champion. Wow. Thanks to Nikki Bella, Paige got a huge, huge win. Anyway. Well, what a night so far Chicago is seeing. We still got more to come. Here's our next matchup. It is part of the tag team tournament. The Golden Truth is a part of it. So I'm pretty sure this is the semifinals. I always get confused. I'm trying to figure it out myself. But this is the semifinals. The Revival did get the Usos out. Like I said, this is a very confusing tingy. But the Golden Truth will go toe-to-toe with Fabreeze. And then there's going to be another tag match next week between the New Day and the Revival. And if they win, or whoever wins that match, we'll go up against them. Like I said, I don't know. I have no clue. Like, I'm always get so confused. Oh my god, I'm confusing myself so badly. Because there's more tag teams. There's like, I think there's like six, but I got rid of, I'm not using the twos, I'm just using the four. But we'll see. I'll show you afterwards. That you are not. I'm pretty sure that's how it'll go. If I'm wrong, then I'll show you at the end of this what I mean. Anyway, we're going to use Fabreeze. Let's go, boy. Let's go, Goldie. Oh! Nice elbow to Gold Dust. Now we've seen these two feud and fight each other. Now we're going to see it one more time, except for a bigger prize. The Tag Team Championships. They are all... Oh, nice move. Oh, what a clothesline to Gold... Oh, man. Look at Fandango. He realized what Gold Dust just did. He's helping out his partner. Oh, Goldust with the reversal. Look at Tyler. Oh, Tyler with the punch. Helping out. Look at this teamwork. Crowd singing Fandango's song. Ref. Both men are back in the ring. And look at this. Whoa. How impressive. Fandango is in control of the match so far against Goldust. And oh, look at Goldust with that counter. Oh, but Fandango with the counter immediately after that. To the corner. Here's a double team tagging in Tyler Breeze. Ooh. Look at these two. Oh, look at R-Truth. Oh, it looked like he was going to go after. Oh, okay. Or just completely ignore going after R-Truth. Never mind. What a spear. And Goldust. Oh, with Tyler Breeze with the reversal. Look at Goldust. These guys are just killing it so far tonight. Oh, Goldust with the reversal. Whoa! Nice move. Oh, it was too late. Damn it. Oh, there was a hot tag right there. R-Truth is now in the match. Oh, and Tyler with the reversal. Look at R-Truth with an uppercut. Look at this. Ooh, what a... Oh! Wow! What is R-Truth planning to do? Oh! Oh my god! Wow! Huge kick to the head. Oh, Tyler with the reversal. Oh, going for an enziguri, but R-Truth saw it coming. I don't know how, but he did go for the pin. One. Oh, Tyler kicks out a one. Oh, I said reverse that shit, but whatever. Go for the pin again. Oh, and Tyler doesn't even kick out at one. Tyler really needs to make a tag if he wants Fabreeze to go to the next round. To the final round. Oh, what the reversal. Oh! Beauty shot! Going for the pin. One, two. Oh, Truth kicks out. That was a close call right there. Now he's throwing R-Truth to his partner, Fandango. There's a tag. Oh! Right into the dancing shoes of Fandango. R-Truth is definitely in trouble. Oh, shit. Stop it. He was taunting for too long. Oh, my God. I said reverse. That was dumb. Nice kick from R-Truth. R-Truth is going to be tagging Goldust, but Goldust is in worse shape than he is. Oh! These guys just know what's coming from them. Oh! And a counter. Looks like Goldust reversed again with an uppercut. Whatever, dude. Man, these guys are in deep trouble. Oh, God. No. Get your ass out of here, dude. Oh, my God. Tyler, help me. What are you doing? Help me. Help me! I can't revert. Oh, thank God. Goldust throws Fandango back in the ring. Oh, look at Goldust! Going for the pin! What? Oh, kick out! Oh, not even a one! How the hell? Oh, what an elbow drop! He's in deep trouble. Oh, what? Look at this. Neck breaker. Nice reversal. He gets the tag. Oh, he's tagging in Tyler Breeze. Look at this. Oh, and away from his partner. Very smart strategy. Oh, but Goldust with the reversal. Uh-oh, look at Goldust getting ready for his finishing move. Looks like Tyler Breeze with the reversal, yes. No! Ah, I think it was going to go for the super kick. Or is that the beauty shot? I don't know. I can't remember what his freaking finishers and signatures. Oh, I could have hit the hot tag. I just realized it. What? Bullshit, dude. I so reversed that. Well, not reversed it, but I so got to him first. Come on. Oh! Oh, still landing on Tyler. Oh my god. Well, that was stupid. Going to the top rope again. What the hell is R-Truth? Finally, Tyler Breeze has something going for him. Oh! He hit it. And Al Fandango is tagged in the match. Why are you focused on him? You're an idiot. Oh my god. If we lose because of your dumb ass. Oh. Thank you. I didn't know what the hell he was doing. He was so far away. One. Oh! Oh my god! And it's Fandango executing the reversal. Are you kidding me right now? Screw this game, dude! What? Oh, I didn't know I could be my partner, too. That's cool. Oh! Look at this! Oh! What a move! Here we go! 1, 2, 3! Fabreeze wins! Thank God. Oh, man. Fabreeze continues on. They are just another step closer to getting the gold. Alright, so now I want to show you what I'm talking about. So hold on. Okay, so I was right. So Fabreeze and the Golden Truth just fought, so Fabreeze continues on. So now the New Day and the Revival will face off, and whoever wins that match will face Fabreeze in the finals. So that's how it's going to go. So, whoever wins this match, this will go on next week. They will face off against Fabreeze, and whoever wins at Clash of the Champions will become the new WWE Raw Tag Team Champions. Let's get ready for our next matchup. Here comes the Big Show. He was part of the worst triple threat match I've ever had, that I've ever watched, and that I've ever participated in. Probably the worst match I've ever been in my entire life. The Big Show versus Titus O'Neil versus Brock Lesnar. But tonight, the Big Show is going one-on-one with the United States Champion. The man that Austin Aries will be facing at Clash of the Champions, Randy Orton. Now, even though Big Show is washed up wrestler, you know, not really worth seeing wrestle anymore. Still not a guy you want to mess with. You know, he's 7 foot tall. He's like 500 pounds or 400 something. He's still not a dude you want to mess with. He's a scary dude. Here comes the Viper now. the United States champion right there. Now, actually, it reminds me, last week on Raw, the Viper punted. Yes, he punted John Cena right in the skull. And we have some good news, and that is that after this, you know, after being able to just chill the rest of the week, John Cena is in good condition, and he, you know, he refused to, you know, not show up for Raw. He is here tonight. He is in the main event against the Beast, his opponent at Clash of the Champions, Brock Lesnar. Because let's just do that, you know. That's one thing I hate about rivalries in this game. They always make you, like, they always book the rivalry match on the show. Like, that's why you wait till the pay-per-view, dude. It's okay if it's like the first week, but this is the third week into the month, into the feud. You're gonna have them fight already? Anyway, Randy Orton's getting ready for action against the Big Show. There he is, Big Show and Randy Orton. Here we
and there's the bell.
Go.
Oh,
nice try, idiot. Woo! Randy Orton starting off with a chop and kicks to the Big Show. Nice letting Big Show get up. Oh, Big Show just throws him away. Throws him away again. Oh, that time he clotheslined his ass. Couldn't do anything about that. And you know Austin Aries is watching very closely, because Aries has to go one-on-one with the Viper once again. Ooh! Man, look at this match. Oh, clothesline to the outside! Another Orton. Oh! To the back of the Big Show. I think Orton was going to do that to Big Show, but Big Show did it first. Oh, what a backbreaker! Orton with the reversal. Now he's back in the ring. Oh, God. Oh, thank gosh. All right. Neckbreaker! Orton now lifting a Big Show up. Oh my, no way. Oh my God. Wow. Oh, what a DDT to the Big Show. One, two, throw. Nearly didn't kick out of that one. Uh-oh, look at Orton getting ready for the RKO. Oh, connect. Oh, but it's a rope break. Big Show's busted open. Orton now going after Big Show. Another clothesline. Whoa, look at Orton going to the top rope again. Not again, but this is the first time tonight. But we rarely see him go up there. What is Orton doing? Oh! Knee drop! This is just a brutal beatdown to the Big Show. Never seen anything like it. No, oh my God. Come on! No, oh my God! He punted Big Show! Just like what he did last week to John Cena. Except Big Show is no John Cena. John Cena recovers quickly. I'm not sure about Big Show. Randy Orton gets the win. And if I was Austin Aries, I'd be scared.
very, very scared.
Orton is a man to be reckoned. You do not want to mess with Randy Orton. He is, I mean, when you say he's dangerous, I mean, he is a dangerous guy. Just punted a 7 foot 400 some pound dude. Austin Aries, you better be ready. Anyway, let's go into our main event. It was the main event of the evening. Here comes the beast, the Raw champion, Brock Lesnar. Michael Cole's right about that. Brock Lesnar, one of the most intimidating things you could ever, ever lay your eyes upon. Brock is a scary dude. Anyone that wants to step up and face him is a brave man. He looks ready to go up against John Cena. He lost to John Cena by a roll-up 2 weeks ago, I believe. Last week he went up. Was it? I can't remember. No, I think it was the first week. I don't know. It was one of the weeks. I just know because of that roll-up, he was able to go one-on-one with Brock Lesnar again at Clash of the Champions. After that, Brock fought in that horrible triple threat match. And he's going up against John Cena once again. Oh my god. I did not plan this. What? Just goes like right up to him. Oh my god. What the hell? Brock Lesnar and John Cena. Here we go. Look at this. Don't be surprised at all if these guys attempt to one up each other in this one. Oh, what a punch! Wait. What the? Looking good so far. What's Brock doing? Any has been absorbed. Is he leaving the match? Well, when you look at the illustrious career of John Cena starting way back to 2002, and since then, I think Brock Lesnar is leaving the match. Brock just completely left. I guess he's just saying, not today. You know, Cena's not too happy about that. He wants a piece of Brock. I don't know why you're tired. You literally didn't do anything except get punched in the face, but John Cena's going to celebrate anyway. Well, that was certainly an interesting way to end Raw. So, anyway, if you guys enjoyed, it's greatly appreciated if you leave the like. And and shared it. Anyways, hope you enjoyed Raw. Next week's episode, or whenever it's going to be, is the last Raw before Clash of the Champions. And then we'll go on to the next month with SmackDown. Anyways, see you next video. Goodbye.